First of all, we have to recall, how do we find out the internal resistance of a cell? Good morning, students. Last session mein humne potentiometer se EMF compare karna, cells ke EMF ko compare karna sikha tha. In today's session, what we are going to do? We are going to find out the internal resistance of a cell using potentiometer. What would be the circuit arrangement for that? Okay, so have a look how we are going to do this. Determination of internal resistance of a cell. See, we consider this as the primary circuit. This one as the primary circuit. What? Only potentiometer, involving only potentiometer. Now what? This entire arrangement, this one, is the external. Okay, external circuit. So, first of all, we have to recall, how do we find out the internal resistance of a cell? So, as you are aware, this is the internal resistance of the cell. Expression for internal resistance of a cell. Let us quickly understand how to find out this internal resistance of a cell. You have got this cell and one external resistance, right? The cell has got EMF and internal resistance. EMF and internal resistance of the cell is this, and this one is the external resistance, right? So this is the cell. Okay, so terminal voltage is what? Terminal voltage is EMF minus I into R. This is the terminal voltage. Terminal voltage of the cell. This we got. Okay. Now, the same voltage would be there across the resistor. Right? Across the external resistor. Is that okay? So, we can put it as V equals IR. So the current will be flowing in this manner, right? V equals IR. I is current, you are aware of that. Now what? If from this one, we need to find out small r, that is internal resistance, what you will get? R is internal resistance. So R will be E minus V by I. E minus V by I, okay? So now what we can do? We can put this I from here, I equals what? V by R. So let us substitute this thing here. So finally we will get E minus V by V into R. So this is our expression for internal resistance. Right. Now what we will do? First of all, there are two steps to do this. In step one, this is open, right? This is open. Only this cell is used. This cell is connected. So we got the null point at this, N1. Null point, N1, where only cell is connected. Only this cell is connected. Now this one, this circuit is not the part of this, right? Right now, key 2 is open. In the open circuit, what will happen? This is only operating. So now what will happen? This is point N1, that is null point, and we will measure the length, balancing length. So this comes out to be, it is like this, E equals K into L1. What is K? K is potential gradient. We had talked about this in the last session. Potential gradient. Now what? This is closed. K2 is closed. Now, from the circuit, from this cell, this external resistance will draw some current. Then what will happen? Then this null point, which we will obtain, will be shifted. It will be obtained at some other point. In that condition, when external resistor is also, call this one, okay? The external resistance is also a part of the circuit. In that condition, the terminal voltage of the cell will be obtained at L2. L2 is the balancing length. Now, if we get the ratio, what we will get? We will have this relation. E by V equals L1 by L2. So this we need to understand. After this, what we will get? We will have this. This could be written as expression of internal resistance we got. So this could be written as E by V minus 1 into R. So finally, what we get is this. Finally, what we get is R equals L1 by L2 minus 1 into external resistance. Right? Is that okay? L1 and L2 are the balancing lengths at two conditions. Two conditions. Condition one, when only cell is connected to the circuit, balancing length is L1. When this K2 is closed, right? Now when this resistance R is also operating, in that condition, balancing length is obtained as at L2. We know the expression for internal resistance to be this, which could be written as, I'm writing it again, E by V minus 1 into R. You can see this. So, can be put in the light of this, R equals L1 by L2 minus 1 into R. So, this is our expression. So, this is how internal resistance of a cell is measured accurately using potentiometer. Potentiometer can be used to determine the EMF of a cell. It can compare the EMF of two cells. It can help us find out the internal resistance of a cell that we have already understood. Okay, now quickly take one question. This question is from NCERT. I have taken it. Then we will move further. So this is the question. 2-volt potentiometer is used for the determination of internal resistance of this cell. So mind it, we have to be very clear about this. The cell whose internal resistance is considered is required to be found out, right? That EMF we require. So EMF of the cell, EMF of cell whose internal resistance is to be found. Internal resistance is to be found. So this is equal to 1.5 volt. Right? This we need to be very careful about, right? They have given this data. This data is not required here. Okay? Next. The balance point of the cell is in open circuit. In open circuit means only cell is connected. When we say open circuit, that means only this one, this cell is connected, right? This external resistor is not operating. Okay? External resistance is not operating. So here L1 is known to us. Okay, what is that? 76.3 centimeter. After that, what happens? When a resistor of this 9.5 ohm So this is external resistance, what? 9.5 is used. The external circuit of the cell balance point shifts to 64.8 centimeter of length, right? So that means earlier, if the wire is taken in this manner, earlier balancing point was obtained here. Now in the second condition, it shifts to this, right? It shifts to this. This is L2. This is L1, right? So L2 is known to us. What is L2? L2 is 64.8 centimeter, right? This is what we are going to get. Now, what is our requirement? We need to determine the internal resistance of the cell. How do we get it? Okay, one thing that we need to understand here, there is a clue given. And what is that clue? This 2-volt meter, 2-volt potentiometer is given. This 2-volt is the EMF of, just have a look, what is given to us. This is a driving cell which has got 2-volt, and there is no internal resistance of this cell. There is no external resistance connected to this. The arrangement which is used here is this, only this, this much. Okay, be very clear about it. So if you look at it, the potential difference across the, let's say now we have this thing, this cell is connected, one key, and then external resistance, and then we have this galvanometer, which earlier it had this, now it shifts to this. This is the basic diagram for this arrangement. This external resistance, this is 1.5 ohm, this is 1.5 volt, this is 1.5 volt, this is 2 volt, this is 1.5 volt, this is galvanometer, okay, this is external resistance, this is key. So this is the basic arrangement given in the question. Okay, this is the basic arrangement given in the question. So what is the value of V that we have in this? L1 by L2 simply. We can simply put this thing. We can simply use this formula. L1, L2 are given. R is also given. Even this is also not required to us. Okay? The very simple way to do this is what? L1 is known to you. This is L1. This is L2. This is L1. This is L1. And this is L2. So earlier, balancing length was obtained at larger value. We have got this value, L1. And then L2. Just put this thing. Substitute the data in this formula, you will get the result. We don't require even this volt or this volt, right? We don't require that. So just calculate this is enough. This is R, we have this clear value given to us, L1 and L2. So that is how the question based on this internal resistance can be found. Okay, now let us talk about the sensitivity. This is very important topic, the sensitivity of potentiometer, right? If sensitivity has to be increased, sensitivity of a potentiometer has to be increased, obviously we would require any device, which is sensitive, right? So first of all, try and understand what is sensitivity of a potentiometer. Agar sensitivity potentiometer ki pata ho jaye, tum kya keh sakte hain ki koi bhi potentiometer pehle to wo kya kaam karta hai, what it does. Potentiometer, potential difference ya EMF, jo bhi measure karta hai wo, ye humne sikha abhi ki kya measure karta hai, wo kya kare, chote se chote value ko bhi accurately measure kar paaye. Wahi uski jo ability hai, that ability is sensitivity of that device. Abhi sensitivity ko lekar ke aap 12th ke bahut sare aise topics hain jahan par device ki sensitivity ke bare mein aapko janna hai. Ek moti si baat jo sensitivity ko lekar ke aapko apne dhyan mein rakhni hai, device sensitive tab hai jab wo choti se choti cheez bhi measure karne ke liye, jo bhi measure karna hai us device ke madhyam se, hum jo bhi measure karte hain choti se choti value bhi wo measure kar paaye. That ability is called sensitivity. So here sensitivity of the potentiometer is what? Ability of potentiometer to measure the small potential difference, small value of potential difference, right? Small value of potential difference or EMF or whatever, whatever it measures, what small value ko bhi measure kar paaye, right? Hum next chapter mein jab jayenge galvanometer ke bare mein padhenge, galvanometer ki sensitivity ke bare mein bhi janenge. Aur bhi bahut sare hain devices jahan par sensitivity ki baat karte hain. So be very careful about it. Okay, ab hamare man mein ye prashn aana chahiye, there must be a question in our mind. What? Okay, we have understood what is sensitivity. Fine, sensitivity of potentiometer we have understood. What should be the criteria for higher sensitivity of a potentiometer? Higher sensitivity ke liye kya honi chahiye? Characteristics kya honi chahiye potentiometer ki? So to increase what sensitivity? To increase sensitivity, kya honi chahiye? Potential gradient should be small. Potential gradient. I'll explain you why this is required. Potential gradient should be small. Should be small. पहले पोटेंशियल ग्रेडियंट एक बार रिकॉल कर लेते हैं. व्हाट इज पोटेंशियल ग्रेडियंट? पोटेंशियल ग्रेडियंट के इक्वल्स वी बाय एल, राइट? एंड व्हाट इज वी? वी इज पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस द पोटेंशियोमीटर वायर. पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अक्रॉस द पोटेंशियोमीटर वायर. यू आर अवेयर ऑफ दिस ए एंड बी. दिस इज द लेंथ, एंटायर लेंथ. तो के इक्वल्स व्हाट? वी बाय एल, right? V by L, this is potential gradient. Now V is what? V A minus V B. V A minus V B, this we have already understood. So in order to increase the sensitivity, potential gradient has to be small. Now this wire has certain resistance. We are aware of that, RW, resistance of the wire, that we are aware. Potential difference means V equals what? I into RW, that has to be there. V equals what? I into RW. Potential difference will be I into RW. Now RW, that's resistance of the wire, we are not changing. We are not changing the resistance of the wire. What can be decreased? Current. If small current, so step one is what? Small current across the across the wire. Second thing, see, if we have small current, that is also one of the ways to do that. If current is small, okay, that is fine. Potential gradient will be small and hence the sensitivity will be large. Higher sensitivity would be when potential gradient is small. For smaller potential gradient, what we require, current should be small. Okay, if you have that arrangement, fine. You can lower the value of current flowing through this wire. Otherwise, what we can do? You should have length longer, longer length wire should be taken. The wire of longer length, longer wire has to be taken, right? So for longer wire, potential gradient will be small and hence the sensitivity will be higher. So second way to do is longer wire is taken, right? So this we need to understand. Sensitivity has higher value when potential gradient is small. So quickly understand this. Sensitivity up, potential gradient small, right? And for this, what, current should be small or length should be large? Is that okay? Is it the basic thing that we can keep in mind? All right. Now, from a given graph, let us take an example. From a given graph, if we have been given a graph of V versus length, how to find out which one of the two potentiometers are more sensitive? So let us have a look. Simply, question, I'm taking this question number one, let's say. There are so many other questions we'll be taking up today. V and L. Graph is like this, 1 and 2. This is potentiometer 1, this is potentiometer 2. Okay. So which potentiometer is? For two potentiometers, we have plotted a graph of V versus length, potential difference versus length. So which potentiometer has higher value, higher sensitivity? Higher sensitivity. Sensitivity. Can you tell me? From the graph, which one has got the larger value of potential gradient? The one with the larger value of potential gradient is less sensitive, right? So if you have a look, you see that for this, just have a look. For the second slope or second potentiometer has got smaller value of potential gradient. So which one is more sensitive? Potentiometer 2 is more sensitive. Potentiometer 2 has smaller potential gradient, hence it is more sensitive, right? this is what we need to keep in mind. From the graph, we can figure out which one is more sensitive. Right? So this thing was there. Okay. One more thing that we need to understand is under what condition potentiometer, you know, balancing length can be obtained in a potentiometer. So I would like you to just keep this thing in mind. Just two things are there. One thing is you need to connect this length, this cell, you know, this cell whose EMF is to be determined with the positive terminal. That was the condition. That is condition number one. Okay. If you are calling it E1, if you are calling this, so this one is driver cell. This one here is the driver cell. This one is called driver cell, and this is operating cell, you can say, right? Driving cell and operating cell. So one thing that has to be there, EMF should be greater than, EMF of driving cell should be greater than the EMF of operating cell. Point number one. Point number two, positive terminal of this cell, operating cell, must be connected to the positive terminal of the potentiometer. This is positive, this is negative, right? Positive terminal. So two conditions are there. Otherwise, what will happen? You will not be able to obtain the balancing point on this wire. Otherwise, you know, more you will move towards B, you will, even if you move to the end of the B, you will not be able to obtain that balance point. The galvanometer will not show any deflection. So two conditions. Condition one is what? Positive terminal of this cell should be connected to the positive terminal of the potentiometer. Number two, the EMF of this driving cell should be greater than this cell, right? So these are the two conditions. Now, in the next session, we will only discuss few numerical problems based on NEET and previous year's NEET questions, right? So, till now, whatever we have done, I would like you to practice properly, okay? See you in the next session. Thank you.